In the previous video, we saw the scalar data types which hold single values. So as opposed to scalar data types, the compound data types hold a collection of values. And we will look into two types of compound data types, tuples and arrays. So first, let's look at tuples. So tuples are a collection of multiple values which can be of same or even different data types. So the same tuple will hold an int, and it can hold another element will be float or character. So these can be different. We will look at arrays, which are also a compound data type, but there we will just keep same data types. And these are comma separated list, and these are stored in parentheses, so represented as a parenthesis followed by elements separated by comma. And these can be same or different types. And destructuring breaks a tuple into parts. So this is an example of destructuring. So this is an example of tuple. And here I have specified the types explicitly. So you see that instead of specifying a single type, as in the case of some of the scalar data types like int or float, here we are specifying a list of data types. Meaning that the first element is I32, second is U8, and third is F32. And here we are assigning three values. And then when we assign this tuple to a set of three variables, X, Y, and Z, then the corresponding values will be stored here. So here X will get the value of 10, Y will get the value of 20, and Z will get the value of 2.5. And then we can access element by dot operator. So these are stored in index starting from 0. So 0, 1, 2. So in order to get the first element, we will call tup.0. Tup is the here name of the tuple. So tup0 will fetch access the first element, element at index 0. Similarly, tup.1 will give you 20. And tup.2 will return 2.5. Now let's look at arrays and see how it's different from arrays. So arrays is also a collection of multiple values, but here it should be of the same data type. And its length is fixed. That means once you have created an array, you cannot add more element after it. And these we will represent in square braces, and elements will be again separated by comma. So this is an example of array. It stores 5 elements, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. And again, index will start from 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So in order to access the first element, we will call arr0. So it will return 10. But if we try to access an element which is beyond this length, for example, here we are trying to access 10th element, but this has just 5 elements. So this is invalid access. So it's an index out of bounds error. And Rust will immediately exit instead of allowing you to do invalid memory access, which can create problems ultimately. So this is an example of Rust's safety principle, that it exits immediately instead of allowing you to access that address. So when should we use arrays? So when we want to allocate data on the stack rather than heap, and when we know the number of elements which are fixed. So we beforehand know that we will not change this list. So we can use array in that case. For example, the days of the week will always remain same. It will consist of these 7 days, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, till Sunday. So in this case, we should use arrays, because it will be stored in, allocated in the stack. And now let's have a quick demo in our IDE. So let's take the same example that we have been looking in the slides. So first I will be taking an example of tuple, and our tuple consisted of three different data types. And these were I32, U8 and F32, and we had assigned the values of 10, 20 and 2.5, and then we did destructuring and we kept three variables x, y and z, and we assigned this tuple to this. So I said that these would get the corresponding values, so let's print those and see whether they get the values in that order or not. So we will do x, y and z, and let's run it. So we see that x got the value of 10, which was stored at first index, because here the first element was x, then y, then z. Similarly, y got value of 20 and z got the value of 2.5. Now we said that we can access the elements using dot operator, elements of tuple. So I is tuple dot 0, then u and again let's print these values to confirm. So I, u and f, and let's run it. So we see that we are able to access the same elements using dot operator. Now let's take an example of arrays. So we created an array of 5 elements. And then we printed, initially we printed first element, and then let's try to access an index which is out of bounds. So 10th element, and we will access here ARR9, and let's see what happens. So we see that we get an error, index out of bounds, length is 5 but the index is 9, and here is the error. So aborting due to previous error, could not compile, so it's not letting us compile. So in this way Rust ensures safety here instead of allowing you to access invalid elements. So now let's comment it out, the invalid case, and run it again, and we see that we are able to access the first element. So that was all for tuples and arrays. You can explore more on it. See you in the next video. Thank you.